On the compressor, you'll see three terminals in either an upward or downward orientation. There's one terminal for the common, one for the start winding, and another for the run winding. While you're here, it's best to test the motor windings to see if it's failed electrically. Set your multimeter to the ohms or resistance setting. First, test the bottom two terminals. This is testing the start and run windings together. You should get a reading of around 10 ohms. Now, test between the start winding and common. You should get a reading around 6 ohms. Next, test between the run winding and common. This will have the lowest resistance at around 4 ohms. Your resistance readings may be a little different, but the two lowest values will add up to the largest value. If there is no resistance in any of the tests, then the compressor has failed and will need to be replaced. You can also test the compressor for short. Test between each terminal to any bare metal on the compressor. Keep in mind this won't work on a painted surface, so you'll likely have to find the ground wire or one of the copper pipes. If there is resistance, then the windings are shorted to ground. Another thing to check is if the terminals are blackened with carbon, as this may prevent a good connection with the starter. You can use steel wool, an emery cloth, or sandpaper to clean the terminals. If the test showed that the compressor is faulty, then you'll need to call a technician. Since this is a sealed system with refrigerant gases, it can't be accessed without the proper tools and training. Now, if you want a complete guide on how to test all the start components, then you can watch our compressor troubleshooting guide. The video is linked in the description below. If you like this and want to see more tutorials and informational videos, then subscribe to our channel. And if you need help, you can call or visit an AMRE location to talk with our knowledgeable staff. Thanks for watching.